Hi, I'm Dr. Gary Namy. Today, let's talk about calling out bullies and the consequences for doing so. Ripped from the headlines of the day comes the story of U.S. Democratic Congressman Alan Grayson from Orlando, Florida's 8th District. Recently, on the floor of the House, he made a very simple presentation lamenting the fact that healthcare legislation was stalled. He put up two simple, apparently homemade, rookie-type posters, implying that in the absence of legislative proposals from Republicans, that the only Republican plan by default had two characteristics.
Here it is, the Republicans' health care plan for America. Don't get sick. That's right, don't get sick. If you have insurance, don't get sick. If you don't have insurance, don't get sick. If you're sick, don't get sick. Just don't get sick. That's what the Republicans have in mind for you, America. That's the Republicans' health care plan. But I think that the Republicans understand that that plan isn't always going to work. It's not a foolproof plan. So the Republicans have a backup plan in case you do get sick. If you get sick in America, this is what the Republicans want you to do. If you get sick, America, the Republican health care plan is this. Die quickly. That's right. The Republicans want you to die quickly if you get sick.
Part of it was tongue-in-cheek, part of it was done for effect, but it was clear talk. Now, the spark for this rare bit of clear talk that's so uncommon in the halls of Congress, or actually anywhere near the D.C. Beltway, for that matter, was a study that he had found, published in a medical journal, that 44,000 Americans die each year for lack of health insurance and the access to medical care that that insurance can provide. He was outraged. We should all be outraged. He was outraged about the outright lying, the dawdling, the stalling, the defensive tactics common to the health insurance reform debate. In subsequent media interviews, he called the Republicans knuckle-dragging Neanderthals and utterly unscrupulous. So here was a man tired of being targeted by congressional bullies, and he stood up. Well, this made the Republicans righteously indignant, who immediately called for an apology and a restoral of decorum. But Grayson stood firm. He said,
"What I said, on the other hand, is the God's honest truth, and truth is an absolute defense."
Now, what lessons for bully targets can be taken from this very public reaction in this political arena to some blunt truth-telling? Well, two major lessons, I think. First, by targeting him for censure and punishment, veteran members of Congress were actually targeting a thoroughly competent and capable whistleblower. From his bio, we learned that he was raised by parents who were both teachers. He was a graduate of an exclusive high school in New York. He completed his Harvard undergraduate education as a Phi Beta Kappa scholar. Then he completed a joint program that gave him a Harvard law degree and a Harvard government school master's degree, later completing a PhD in government. So this guy's no intellectual slouch. In life and in practice, he became an expert on fraud committed against the government as a practicing attorney and later whistleblower advocate. In between, he started and ran a nonprofit charitable organization for 22 years, and he also made a fortune by entrepreneurship in the high-tech industry. But what most seems to motivate Alan Grayson is justice. He even has a quote from Deuteronomy on his biographical page. So, thus targets, like Grayson, are nearly always brighter than the opponents who try to tear them down. It seems like we've got a brilliant man calling Neanderthals, Neanderthals. The second lesson to take from the Alan Grayson episode is that exposing bullies is risky. All targets know this. Alan Grayson incurred the wrath of Wolf Blitzer and a cohort of Republican spokespeople. You see, truth-telling, when it's contrasted with the lies and rationalizations that bullies fabricate, can have one of two effects because of its candor. The first effect is for bully apologists and their supporters to reflexively react defensively. They want to circle the wagons and protect the exposed bully and to attack the truth-teller. In real-life organizations, targets are branded troublemakers, with 64% being banished from their organizations. The second effect of candor is that blunt, clear, unequivocal, non-politically correct talk is liberating to people who are too timid to say what they have on their minds. They believed it should be said, but they wait on others to say it, and Grayson did such a thing. So to the silent, inactive co-worker witnesses to bullying on a daily basis, the brave gunslingers like Representative Grayson show how it can be done. So thank you, Mr. Grayson. Let's take his example and mobilize in our workplaces and start talking straight about the shameful bullying conduct that is all too readily accepted in our workplace. Please visit the Workplace Bullying Institute online at workplacebullying.org. Thank you.